Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Ravi Singh and I'm going to help you understand great engineering concepts around us. For that, you just need to hit the subscribe button down below.
This video is made for the purpose of answering the question which I gave you in the previous video, and the question was, why is it necessary to defrost, that is free of accumulated ice, the refrigerator? So I'm giving you some moments to think about it. Just think.
To begin with, let us see what the dew point temperature is at first. So we already know from one of my previous video that air is a mixture of dry air plus water vapor, and the amount of this water vapor, this water vapor amount decreases as we are going to decrease the temperature of the air. That is, the air will release the moisture contained within it if we are going to decrease the temperature. So if I'm going to make the TS diagram of air, like this. So suppose air is at a particular vapor pressure, that is PV, and we are not disturbing this vapor pressure, that is the actual condition. Okay, this is at a particular vapor pressure air, and we are starting to decrease the temperature. Say we are here at a particular point 1, and we are starting to decrease the temperature of this air at a constant pressure, and that pressure is vapor pressure. Okay, so we will just go like this, and eventually we come at a point which is nothing but the saturated vapor point. That is, we are staying at a particular vapor pressure, constant vapor pressure, and we are decreasing the temperature of the air. So eventually we come at a saturated vapor point, and if we are going to decrease a temperature further, that is, we are going to remove some more heat, then condensation will begin. That is, a liquid droplet will form just before this point, just after this point here. A liquid droplet will begin to form, like condensation happens. Okay, just after this point, in this direction, just after this point. Okay, this liquid droplet will form, that is, condensation will begin. So this saturated point, this saturated line, or we say this point, is what we call as the saturated temperature, or it is manifested in terms of dew point temperature. So what is the dew point temperature? That is, at a constant vapor pressure, if you are going to decrease the temperature, we will reach at a point where the condensation is just about to begin. That point is saturated point, and the temperature at that point is what is known as the dew point temperature. So if we are going to decrease the temperature even further, then liquid will condense. That is, we will get liquid droplets if we are going to decrease the temperature, because after this it will not follow this, because here the temperature and pressure is a function of each other. Here both are not dependent but dependent upon each other. So we cannot make the pressure constant and decrease the temperature, because if we are going to decrease the temperature, then obviously pressure will decrease, so we will shift below, and hence the liquid droplets will form like this, because inside this liquid droplets are there. Here superheated vapor, no any liquid, so inside this liquid droplets will form. So this is what happens in case of refrigerator. Suppose this is the evaporator of refrigerator. Okay, and the temperature of this evaporator is below this dew point temperature, because at dew point temperature the condensation just begins, but no any liquid droplet is formed. So just below the dew point temperature, or say substantially below the dew point temperature, liquid droplets will form. So now we are having liquid droplets, and it is below the dew point temperature, so we are having the liquid droplets. And if the temperature is also below the freezing point of water, that is if the temperature is below the 0 degrees Celsius, then this liquid droplet will freeze, or it will convert into ice. It will get converted into ice, and this is what is known as frost. So this is how the frost formation happening in case of our household refrigerator. So the condition is that the evaporator temperature must be less than the dew point temperature. Evaporator temperature is must be less than dew point temperature, DPT, and it must be less than freezing temperature of water, so that water can freeze and it will form ice, and that is what is manifested in terms of frost formation in case of refrigerator.
So what are the reasons behind this frost formation? As we have seen, that the basic requirement for frost formation is the presence of air containing moisture inside the refrigerator, and the sources of this moist air are, number first, that is moisture migration from the stored food products. Number second, periodic door openings. And number third, door gasket leakage. So what are the effects of this frost formation? Number first, in a typical refrigeration system, it is the cold airflow at a particular flow rate from the evaporator that cools the refrigerator compartments. But due to frost accumulation on evaporator, there is an increase in pressure drop of the cold air on their way to the compartments, resulting in a smaller air mass flow rate and hence a lower heat transfer rate from the products inside the compartments to be cooled. Therefore, frosting results in an increased energy input to accomplish the same refrigeration effect. Number second, although a moderate amount of frost on the evaporator may increase the rate of heat transfer through increased surface roughness, induced turbulence, and increased surface area, too much frost is detrimental to the operation of refrigerator, as it acts as an insulator between the air and the refrigerant, resulting in a lower heat transfer. Thus, refrigerators must be periodically defrosted in order to maintain acceptable efficiencies. So again, I'm giving you a question, and I hope that you all will answer it in the comment section below. And the question is, even though sound travels faster in warm air, it travels farther in cold weather. Why? So just think about this question and stay healthy, stay safe, and stop COVID-19 by taking precautions. Thank you.
Also, for more exciting contents about science related stuffs in the form of news, videos, or articles, don't forget to like our page Science Talk on Facebook, for which the link is given below.